Welcome back to the channel, guys. This is Wolfsman Gaming, and we are back again with more Star Wars Jedi Knight Jedi Academy. But this time, it is for review. As you can see, I'm now on multiplayer, but there is literally no one playing the game. So, what I'll be doing is... What you see now, it's literally just me going against bots, unfortunately, because there's no one else playing the game. So, that's fun, right? But, it's fine. It's fine. So with those done, let's talk about this game. It originally came out in 2000 and... To be honest, I don't know when the game came out. I think it was 2004. I want to say 2004. It's based after Return of the Jedi. You're a Jedi Padawan... by the name of Jaden. You get to choose to be either male or female. You're under the supervision of Cal Kestis. No, not Cal Kestis, what am I talking about? Kyle Katarn, sorry. As you can see, the lightsabers are actually really impressive for when the game actually came out. Throughout the story, you have to hunt down the Sith cult of Ragnos before the Sith Lord Ragnos can be resurrected. That's the word I was looking for. There are force powers in the game. A lot of force powers in the game. I chose the Jedi side first because I know it's not the canon ending to the game, the Sith ending is, but I am a Jedi in life and in death, so I thought might as well go with being a Jedi in the game because Jedi are the best, to be honest. You do meet Luke Skywalker in-game. You go to many places that get mentioned in Legends and even in the movies like Hoth. You have to fight against your will of the dark side later on. But the game is really good. I loved the game when I was young. I always only played the duel mode. Me and my brother would always like kill each other because it was fun. But I never actually did the single player when I was young until I did walkthrough. So playing the story for the first time on the channel was actually really good. I love that. The story itself is really good. I couldn't believe how good the game actually was. Yes, there was a lot of hard parts of the game. That it's inevitable when you're making a Star Wars game. You have to make sure there are bits of the game that is harder than others. So your path of becoming a Jedi Knight is a lot more... a lot more difficult than you would have hoped it would be. But, yeah, the game is really good. This is the remastered one for PlayStation 4. But, yeah, if you love Star Wars and you really want to give this game a shot, then go for it. I mean, I got my copy in-game. For $26.99, it came along with the second game, Jedi 2 Jedi Outcast, which is a complete sequel to this game, which is really, really, I'm looking forward to playing that. I don't think I ever, actually I did play it, I played on the original Xbox, but I only played the dual mode again. I never did the single player, so it's gonna be really, really interesting to see what it's like compared to this one. So I'm looking forward to playing that. But this game, even though it's the remastered one, they didn't really do much else to the game. They just ported over from the original consoles to PlayStation 4. They upgraded the servers so you can actually find more people. But apart from that, there wasn't really anything else they did to the game. The game is exactly how it played back on the original Xbox. But even with that, the game is really, really impressive. The graphics are amazing. The story's good. The frame rate's amazing. There's no bugs in the game. So, yeah, if you're a big Star Wars fan and you want to collect all the Star Wars games or even just play them all, then pick this game up in your closest game shop. Like I said, I got mine for £26.99. So, it's not that expensive for two games, two classic Star Wars games. So, yeah. Yes, I admit they could have done better with the graphics, like instead of just porting over, why don't they could have just remade it with nowadays graphics, but this is still a good game. A lot of people don't say it is, but it was my childhood, one of my childhood Star Wars games I always played. When I was having a crappy day at school or whatever, I always came home and played this along with Battlefront 2 from 2005. But these games were my lifeline when I was young. So, yeah. But I'm not going to let that judge the game how it is now. With this game, I'm going to give it a 7. A 7 out of 10. Because the games were made for kids. But you dismember people. And some of the missions are near impossible to do. But apart from that, the game is amazing. The Force powers are amazing. Some of the enemies don't die, but well, they do die, but you need skills. But apart from that, the game is really good. So, I do recommend it. But it's a 7 out of 10 for me. That's the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, hit that like button, turn that notification bell on, join the Wolfgang, which is now 252 strong. Thank you guys so much. And I will see you in the next video. Until then, Wolfsbane Gaming, signing off.